first thing I did was loosen the lace wig, of course. So it's all loosened up for when I have to take it off to bleach the knots. And the second thing I did was section off the hair because I want to, I think I'm going to just like fully bleach like a section like right here, and then I'm going to highlight the rest. And then the rest of this hair, I'm going to just bleach in sections. Like, I'm not going to bleach the whole thing or the whole ends or whatever. So, yeah, that's the first step I'm going to do. I'm doing it in my room, so I'm going to, like, be back and forth because I'm doing it in there. And then I'm just going to come in here to film the clips, like, the important parts, because it's better light so you guys can see or whatever. So, yeah, I'll be back. Okay, so now what I did was just take the two portions that I was talking about that I was just going to highlight the most, that I want to have super, super blonde, and I twist them up so it wouldn't get on my face or whatever, and yeah, so that's the first thing I did. Okay, so now what I've done was just take some random pieces out of the layer and just highlighted them. So I didn't wrap them up in foil, no reason to. So yeah, I took some random ends over here and some random pieces over there and right there. But I have like the most highlighted pieces right here. Gloves are wet. But yeah, so now what I'm going to do is do some streaks in the ponytail and up here and up here and in here. So yeah, stay tuned for that. Alright, so the next thing I did was just grab two chunky layers right in here, wrap them up, and just grab little pieces around, you know, just, I did it randomly because I didn't want it to look like, I don't know what to call it, but I just didn't want to look too like I went to the salon. I just wanted to look a little natural, you know. So I just took random pieces, like I said, I just took random pieces around here, in here, and then the two chunky layers right there. So when I take it off, I'll probably check the back to see if there are enough highlights in the back, but yeah, I'm just testing it out, like I said. But yeah, so I'm gonna wait, let this sit, make sure it starts changing, and I'll be back when it's time to wash out. So I took it off to do the back because there was a lot of highlights missing in the back, and this is the consistency that I mixed it to. I didn't do any like measurements. I just put like a scoop and a quarter of the bleach. And so I took it off to do the back because there was a lot of highlights missing in the back, and this is the consistency that I mixed it to. I didn't do any like measurements. I just put like a scoop and a quarter of the bleach, and like I just poured it and mixed it until I was happy with the consistency. So yeah, that's about it, nothing special. But yeah, I'm gonna apply the rest of this to the back of the hair, and I'll be back. All right guys, so this is how the wig looks right now, and then the front. So I still don't think it's enough highlights in the back or whatever, but I can always go back and do it anyway. So like I said, I'm just gonna let that sit because it's probably going to need a while. So yeah, and I'll probably keep checking periodically. So yeah. Alright guys, so I just wanted to show you how the hair has lightened. You can see by the two chunky layers that it has lightened really well and hasn't even been on that long. So the hair takes really, really well, but I want this like super, super blonde. So I'm going to continue to leave that on there for like about 10 more minutes or so, and then I'm just going to wash it out if it doesn't lighten as blonde as I want it to, but I want that real, real nice blonde. So yeah, once again, and I'm going to deep condition with the Rapid Repair from Beautiful Textures, one that I use on my natural hair. It's really, really good. So I decided to use on this since technically this hair is naturally curly. So, and then I'm going to wash with the Moroccan Argan Oil Shampoo from Organics. Feel free to use any organic, Argan or shampoo or any moisturizing shampoo and conditioner for the hair, because the hair is going to be really, really dry once you're done with the bleaching. So you're going to need a really, really good deep conditioner and shampoo to make sure to take all the chemicals out. So that's what I'm going to do. And when I'm ready to wash in about 10-15 minutes or so, I'll be back to show you guys how it looks once it's rinsed out. So what I did is I just gave her a really quick rinse over, and oh gosh, she looks so pretty in its curly state. I mean, like this. I think it's really cute. So this is her. It's more of like a brown. It looks a little brassy to me, but whatever. I think she's cute curly with it, so I don't know how she looks straight. I hope I'm not coming out of frame. But hold on, let me come over a little bit. And I bleached the knots, and they look great. Like, let me see. Like, they look much better than they did before. Like, it's not as noticeable as before. So I'm gonna finish washing and conditioning her, and then probably when she dries and everything, I'll come back and show you guys. So be back. Alright, so I just wanted to come to you guys really quick to show you the amount of shedding that I got this time, and I'm super duper pleased. This is it. Through detangling and combing, washing, rewashing, detangling, combing again, that's the little amount of shedding that I got. So I'm super happy with that, and it better to only give me that little bit of shedding. And there's one strand left on the counter. It better to only give me that little bit of shedding after it gave me so much when I first washed it and cleared it out. But I have it in the microwave deep conditioning for about 2 minutes first, and I'm going to check it, and then I'll probably put it on for, you know, 2 minute intervals or so I can get that real deep penetrating effect. But yeah, I'm super happy with the way it's looking now and how it turned out so far. So I'm probably not going to show you guys until in the morning when it's dry, because it's like almost 12 o'clock at night. I'm not going to be up all night with this hair, so yeah, I'll probably see you guys in the 8 a.m. Oh, and just in case I don't come back, like, tonight to show you guys what oil I'm going to put on the hair while it's air drying, it's going to be the Creme Nature polishing oil with a little dab of the anti-frizz oil from Organic Root Stimulator that I use, so yeah. But that's it for right now. You guys have a good night, and see you in the morning. Bye. Alright, morning guys. So it's about 80%, I'd say, yeah, 80% dry. It's still pretty damp and a little wet in some spots. Got two strands just now. But anyway, and I really love her. I really, really love her. I just have to scrape out some of that loose bleach in the scalp, as you can see, from where the hair shedded. Like, it came through the loose holes and whatnot. So, yeah, just gotta scrape that out. No big deal. And I just have a bobby pin down for right now. And I really, really love this color. And I think she'll look so bomb when I straighten her back out. So let me show you guys the back. Hopefully you guys won't be seeing any track, because I find that ever since I got that big ball of shedding, like right here, has been a little bald. So, but when this wig dries, she'll be full again, because when she's curly, she's really, really full when she's dry. So yeah, that's how she came out. I'll probably add the clip in when I am straightening her back out, if I decide to right in here. But if I don't, then I will talk to you guys later, but hopefully I will. Alright, so bye. Alright guys, so I am back. Hold on, What? Right. Sorry. I zoomed in by mistake. I was trying to figure out which button it was to zoom out. But yeah, this is her all straightened out. I still haven't glued her back down, so if you see some flapping, then don't worry about it. But y'all, I am telling y'all, look. Look at that. Beautiful. Like, it's so soft. Like, it's still soft just like before. Like, I'm having no problems. Let's see. I got one. Yeah, that's one. Two. Two strands and one just dropped. So that's three strands just now. But, whatever. Like, check this body. Like, oh my god. Like, I know how some people say the hair, like, changes texture after you bleach or whatever. Mm-mm. Not this. After that deep conditioning, like, this hair... Did I get one more? Thought I did. But this hair just, like, it feels the same. Like, it's still soft and beautiful. And I used a 40 developer. Did I? Keep feeling hair, but that's probably brushing up against this or... A loose hair then. Okay, one loose hair then. Anyway, but yeah, like... I don't know what I'm gonna call this though. Probably like my Olivia / Ciara inspired look. I don't know. Don't quote me on that though. Because this is not the Olivia look I planned to do. It just came out looking kinda-ish that way. And Ciara-ish. So, probably gonna name it that. But I'm gonna do a tutorial on Olivia's hair specifically. Because I love that hair she had in Love & Hip Hop. But yeah, y'all. Like, love it. And what I did to get the brassiness out, because you guys know it looks a bit orange instead of like more brown. When I put my deep conditioner on it, I put it in the microwave for about 10 minutes last night. And then like, because I put in a 3-minute interval and a 2-minute interval. And then the last one I did was a 5-minute straight interval, whatever. And then when I squeezed out all the water, all the orange just came out into the... bowl. So that's one way. If you don't want to buy a neutralizing shampoo, you can try that. Put your deep conditioner on it, put some water in it, and like leave it on for 10 minutes or so, and when you squeeze it out,